Welcome to an example on how to use the one variable stat tool on the T84 to determine the five number summary of a data set. The five number summary is given here below, where we have the minimum, the first quartile, the median, the third quartile, and the maximum. So the first step is to enter the data, so we press stat, enter. Let's clear the old data from both of these columns, so we'll go to the top of the column, press clear, and then enter. This clears the entire column. So go to the top of L1, press clear, and enter. And now we'll enter the given data in L1. So we have 2.6, enter, 3.5, enter, and so on. Now that we have the data in L1, we want to run the one variable stat tool. So we press stat, right arrow once to calculate, and notice how the first option is one var stats, which is what we want. So we can press 1, or because 1 is already highlighted, we can press enter. Our data is in L1, so we do want L1 next to list, which we already have. If it was in a different list, for example list 2, we'd press second 2 for list 2. But notice how here under frequency list we have L2. We don't have a frequency table, so we do need to clear this L2 under the frequency list. So we can press the down arrow or enter, clear this, press enter, and enter again to calculate. And now we'll find the five number summary values on the next screen. So we press the down arrow. Notice the min is 2.6. The first quartile is 12.15. The median is 21.65. Third quartile is 26.15. And the max is 28.2. These values are the five number summary. We can use the five number summary to create a box and whisker plot. I do want to mention there's more than one method in order to calculate Q1 and Q3, so it's important to make sure in your class that you do use the same method the calculator is using in order to find quartile 1 and quartile 3. The TI83 graphing calculator uses the formula 0.25 times the quantity n plus 1 to calculate the position of the lower quartile, and 0.75 times the quantity n plus 1 to calculate the position of the lower quartile. TI graphing calculators return the average position, or the mean, between the measurements instead of the exact position or rounding to a particular position used in some stat software packages if the position is a decimal. And in fact, for our class, we don't use the same method as a calculator to find Q1 and Q3. We use the method outlined here above. So before using the calculator for the five number summary, just make sure your class uses the same method as a TI graphing calculator. I hope you found this helpful.